My back. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's terrible. Oh, I gotta get this video out.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. As you can see by the intro, we doing some Spider-Man related content today. Can you check the date for me real quick on your side of things? Just check the date for me real quick. What's today's date? December 17th, 2023. You know what took place 2 years ago today? Today, 2 years ago in 2021? The premiere of the best Spider-Man live action movie of all time, Spider-Man No Way Home. Since it's the 2 year anniversary of Spider-Man No Way Home, why not drop a ranking of the Spider-Man movies from worst to best? I got my live action dolls with me so you guys can't hold me and say, "Bro, you're not a true Spider-Man fan, your ranking sucks." I got my Funkos right here. Fuck wrong with him. And yeah. Yeah, you wanna go band for band? Let's go fucking Spider-Man movie for Spider-Man movie. I got them all. In order. Fuck wrong with me. I just had to show y'all in a smooth mannerism that I really do this Spider-Man stuff. And you seen the shirt earlier from the little skit I had done a little earlier in the video. So now, let's just get to the rankings. We're gonna start in order now. First, we got Spider-Man 1. The first live-action Spider-Man movie starring Tobey Maguire. This movie started off the franchise, feel me? I'ma go to tier. Go to tier movie. Norman Osborn is the villain. MJ being a thought as usual in this movie. This shit was active, boy. They was boxing in this movie. Tobey's Peter was so amazing. This shit was good as fuck. It's goated. It's a goated movie. I don't think it's the best Tobey movie, but I think it's goated. It kick-started the market for big-name superhero movies. I know people are going to say, "Well, Blade did this, this did that, X-Men, da-da-da-da." Tobey's Spider-Man movie was a fucking hit. I think it really stamped that there really, truly was a market for superhero movies. That's why Tobey's Spider-Man is right there. Next, we got Spider-Man 2, where MJ was being the most thottiest bitch fucking ever. Bro, I fucking hate MJ in these fuck ass movies, man. But this movie is fucking god tier. Otto Octavius, the train scene, the boxing, the amount of hands Toby done put on that nigga, fuck wrong with him. Like the ending fight where that nigga was holding up the billion shit, he flipped that shit over. He was like, "Yeah, nigga, I'm Spider-Man type shit. Fuck are we talking about, nigga?" Like that nigga was active the whole entire fucking movie. The bond between Otto and Peter was fucking amazing, boy. Motherfucking, oh, this shit was good, boy. I'm out to watch this hoe, boy. Fuck wrong with you. This shit really peaked, bruh. And them niggas was boxing on the fucking skyscraper and shit near the bank and shit. That shit was active. That nigga webbed that nigga up, took the little slide. He said, "Give me that," flung that bitch back to him. Fuck wrong with you. That nigga Toby had the best hands in this movie, bruh. This shit was active, boy. God tier movie, first, hands down. It's a god tier movie, feel me? Spider-Man 3. Yeah, that shit's... it's mad, bro. Like, it's Spider-Man 3, bro. I feel like the issue with Spider-Man 3 is that it tried to do so much in one movie. And I didn't like that shit, bro. There was motherfucking Sandman, motherfucking Venom, Peter with the symbiote. What's his face? Harry finding out that he was Spider-Man. That nigga became Green Goblin Jr. Shit like that. It was just, bruh. It was hella shit going on in this movie, bro. I just felt like there was no, like... I know there was, like, a path, but I didn't feel like... I felt like nothing was, like, straightforward in this movie, bro. This movie... And, oh, my God. The only thing good about this movie is when Peter smacked the fuck out of MJ, bro. That shit was dope as fuck. I like to see that. I'd do the same thing without the symbiote, though. Fuck wrong with him. So, Toby, your movies are concluded. Next, we got Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man 1. I don't care what y'all niggas say, bro. This shit's on the same tier as Spider-Man 1, bro. This movie was, I love the darker tone it took on Peter Parker and Spider-Man, bro. The CGI was great. The lizard was dope to see. Oh my gosh. The relationship between Peter Parker and Gwen Stacy in this movie was, oh my gosh. It was literally perfect. Best love interest, live action, hands down. Uncle Ben's death was, oh my god. Uncle Ben's death was crazy, bro. All the acting in Andrew's movies felt so much more natural. He felt like he like really was putting his all into the movie. He was the best actor for Spider-Man. Like, oh my god, this is so good, bro. I just really liked the darker tone it took. And the web swinging scenes, oh my gosh. And he had a little lengthy spider too. He literally has he was the only Spider-Man with Spider-Man-like mannerisms. Like, oh my gosh. Dude, this movie was amazing. Like, oh my god, this movie is so good. That nigga got his shit dead by the lizard. Fuck wrong with him, boy. Nigga got his shit. Lame ass nigga. I like when Peter got shot and he couldn't really swing that well. And the kid that he saved earlier's dad was like the nigga with the cranes and shit. And he lined all of them up so that he could swing as fast as he can to get to where the lizard was at, bro. Oh my gosh. That shit was clean as fuck. That shit was hella clean, bro. Such a good movie, bro. Goated tier. Way better than Spider-Man 3. I don't care what y'all niggas say. This shit way better than Spider-Man 3. Oh my goodness. Chasm 2 on the other hand. Ass is ass, bro. I like, bro. Electro, Harry with the Green Goblin and all the, I'm getting sick, I need Spider-Man's blood to heal me. Nah, 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 nah. Like, nigga, shut the fuck up, nigga. Like, watch out. The Rhino was weak as hell. That nigga was sorry as shit in this movie, bro. Like, everything, there was just so much shit going on. Like in Spider-Man 3, like, there was just, like, no, like, direct, like, path. Like, everything was just, like, thrown at you in this movie. It was just, like, Sony fucked up. Sony fucked up on my nigga Andrew Garfield, bro. It was just everything. But the suit, though? The suit, though? Yeah, that's the number one live-action suit, bro. That suit's fucking clean. It's not my favorite, but I know for a fact it is the best live-action suit, fuck wrong with me. I really want to like this movie. I really do. But I do enjoy it. I just, like, if I'm ranking it, it's definitely the worst. Like, there's no doubt about it. Andrew, your movies are concluded. Great actor, great castings, just Sony fucked y'all up, man. Sony did y'all niggas bad, bro. Now, my nigga Tom Holland, fuck wrong with him. Dang, it's goated. Spider-Man Homecoming, bro, oh my god, that's in my top 10 MCU movies, bro, all time, bro. That shit's dope as fuck, bro. Like, my nigga Peter in that movie, bro, the relationship with Ned, Aunt May and shit. We have Tony as his mentor, bro, that shit was active, boy. The fucking vulture, bro. Oh my god. Everything about this movie was so, it really felt like high school. Like, cause in the past movies, Toby's Peter Parker was in college. I don't even know what grade Andrew was in. I think that nigga was in high school. But like, this shit truly felt like a high school ass movie. Like, everything about it, like, he felt like a kid. Like, it was so cool. Like, and Iron Man himself, bro. If you're nothing without this suit, you shouldn't have it. The mentor-student aspect between Tony and Peter was very good in this movie. I really liked it because he doesn't got like an Uncle Ben and shit, all that. So he's really just looking out for Aunt May. But Tony swooped in and he took care of my dog, bro. Gave my nigga a clean-ass suit. Like, that shit was dope, bro. And the final fight at that little carnival, John, where he's stopping him from taking all the Avengers equipment because it was moving day. Oh my god, that shit was dope, bro. I just wish from Tom Holland's movies in general, we get more swinging scenes. We don't really get, like, swinging scenes. That's what makes Spider-Man like Spider-Man, especially live-action, is the swinging scenes. And we don't really get that much. The most we got in was in Far From Home. Speaking of Far From Home, I don't know how I feel about Far From Home. Cause it's a good movie, but like, it has a lot of meh moments. Like Flash Thompson and that one tall Asian nigga, that nigga pissed me the fuck off, bro. That nigga was hella like, what are we doing? And Mysterio as a fucking villain, oh, that nigga was so fucking annoying. And he fucking doxed my nigga at the end of the movie after that nigga got boxed up with his eyes closed. Like, you fucking dumb bitch. I don't know where to put it. Like, there's a lot of great scenes in that movie. Like, him and MJ in this movie, their dynamic was so good. Like, oh my gosh. Like, seeing them two niggas fall in love with each other, bro, that shit was clean. They had that little weird-ass kiss in that movie, but everybody kissing be awkward when it comes to niggas that they fall in love with for the first time. But what's stopping me from putting it in the med tier is that there's peak-ass scenes, bro. Like, when he was making his suit and it reminded Happy of how Tony used to be. Like, that little parallel was so fucking clean. Like, oh my god. And then when he went to go box the drones, bro, he's swinging and shit. Oh my god, bro, that shit was so clean. Like, that's one of my favorite Spider-Man sequences, live action of all time. Like, what fucked me over was that Maria Hill and Nick Fury were fucking Skrulls the whole fucking time. That shit had me so hot. Like, what the fuck? The Met scenes is like, bro, they're Met as fuck. Like, oh my god. When that nigga was naked and that Asian nigga pulled up, bro, oh my gosh. That nigga was a whole ass nigga the whole movie, bro. It's just, I don't know, bro. I don't know how I feel. And like Ned and that one little announcer girl, that shit was like, that shit could go, bro. It was like, I don't really care for it. It's a good movie. It's a good movie. That shit's clean as fuck. It's better than TASM 2 and it's better than Spider-Man 3. That's for sure. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, that's good, bro. Your movie dropped 2 years ago today, bro. Today, bro. We already know where this shit's going, bro. Spider-Man No Way Home over every single Spider-Man live action movie, bro. Fuck are we talking about, bro? I'm not even gonna talk about all three Spider-Mans in one, bro. MJ, Ned, and Peter, like, them as a trio, this movie was fucking sick, bro. The spell, the fighting. Oh my god, the fighting. This movie is special, man. This movie is special, man. Obviously, we got all three Spider-Mans and the villains and the final fight, everything. But it's just like, the acting and the roles of each character in this movie, main character at least, was just so significant to the story. Like, oh my gosh. Doctor Strange fucking up his spell 6 times. He wanted to remember Peter. He wanted to remember Peter. Like, what? What are we talking about? Aunt May's dead? Green Goblin was acting like, oh my god, don't even start on Green Goblin. That nigga was acting like a whole ass nigga. Him and Aunt May just don't cooperate. He done fucking threw that bomb in Aunt May in Toby's movies, bro, when she was mid-prayer. Like, this nigga is psycho. And he was talking about your holy moral mission. And like, bro, he was dropping that nigga from floor to floor. Peter was punching that nigga and he smiled and giggled. He started giggling and laughing. Like, what the fuck? When all three live action came together, bro, it was amazing. Like, the scene on top of the high school where they were talking about, like, their lives and stuff, and Andrew's like, I'm pulling my punches. Like, it was dope. Obviously, we got the little pointing meme, and we got to see them interact with each other, talk about Toby's natural webs and shit. Like, they're just, oh, this movie is so good. And Tom versus Green Goblin at the end of No Way Home is the best live action fight of all time in Spider-Man movies. That fight was insane. We had never seen Peter box like that ever. The last time we seen Peter box for real was in Spider-Man 2. He was fucking boxing Green Goblin, bro. I think it was like, what, 17 punches? He flipped that nigga over and shit. Fuck are we talking about? He made that nigga eat them fucking punches, nigga. Bro, what are we fucking talking about, bro? And the movie theater experience, like, I was too young to see, like, Toby's movies in theaters. I seen Andrew's movies in theaters. But the in-theater experience with everybody, because we all felt literally the same exact emotions, along with the TikTok edits and shit, everybody hyped as fuck. Everything on social media is just Spider-Man, Spider-Man, Spider-Man. Like, oh my god, it was such a good era. But the movie theater experience, literally, like, everybody as a whole, and it was opening night. So it was the 16th. So I came to school Friday with all the knowledge in the world, bruh. Nigga was talking sweet to me. Nigga, you want me spoiling No Way Home for you, nigga? This movie was good, bro. This movie was magical. I'm finna cry thinking about it, bro. That's the best live-action Spider-Man movie. I don't give a fuck what y'all need to say, bro. Like, this... bro, I love No Way Home, bro. That shit's good, bro. We got Into the Spider-Verse and Across the Spider-Verse, bro. And Into the Spider-Verse... Ooh, better than Spider-Man 2, for sure. Like, that movie... That's just, bro. The leap of faith scene is all I gotta say. I don't even want to get into it like that, bro, because it's just like there's so much to talk about in just one movie. Like, it's so, like, it's so good. Like, oh my gosh. I'm just thinking about it. That shit good, bro. That shit peak as fuck, bro. Now, Across the Spider-Verse, now that I'm really thinking about it, the spot, the voice acting in the movie, the soundtrack, my nigga, Metro! Yeah, bro, that shit was dope, bro. Him boxing all the Spider-Man niggas. And we got this, and the whole canon event theory and shit. We got to see hella iterations of Spider-Man. We got, bro, yeah, no, I'm tweaking. What the fuck? Now that I'm really thinking about this shit's god tier as hell, bro. Like, what the fuck? This shit's hella fucking good, bro. Oh my gosh. Nah, I'm gonna do my own thing. Ooh! My nigga Shameik Moore ate that shit, nigga. What are we talking about, bro? So here is the final list, feel me? We got, in last place, we have Tasman 2. Sorry. Just sit your ass down. Then we got Spider-Man 3, Tobey Spider-Man 3. Shit was Far From Home, good, feel me? Then we got Homecoming, Tasm 1, Spider-Man 1. And then got tier, top 4, we got Across the Spider-Verse, Spider-Man 2, Into the Spider-Verse, and No Way Home, baby. Fuck are we talking about, bro? Like, just Spider-Man in general is just like such a good character. They really fucked my nigga Andrew up. Cause when he entered No Way Home, he stole the whole show, bro. He stole the movie, bro. It was bro. I love Spider-Man, bro. Rip Stan Lee, that's my nigga, bro. Y'all agree with my rankings, yes or no? Because I feel like this is pretty accurate. Like, I feel like every Spider-Man fan, not just a Spider-Man fan, but just like any fan that's seen these movies, all of them, could agree with this list. I don't think anything's bad for me. Like, I feel like some people gonna say something about Far From Home and Tasm 1. But it's like, bro, Tasm 1 is good. Like, what are we talking about? That shit's goaded as hell. Like, that shit's good, bro. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you guys like, share, comment on your picks, on what you think you would change on your personal list. And subscribe to the channel. Subscribe. We're on the road to 500 subs. Here's the current sub count. Here's what we're trying to reach. Fiction fam, we on the way up. If you ain't up, you down, feel me? I'll catch y'all next time. See ya.